So what are the new challenges? Well, firstly, everyone, patients, families, oncologists, the rest of healthcare needs to give up this either-or thinking. It's not either curative or palliative. The two can go together. The second issue is this one of giving up hope. It's not just hope for a miracle or hope for a cure, hoping for a good life, hoping for high quality, hoping for the life to be as good as possible is as good an object of hope as others. We must fund the fellowships. We must develop the oncology models as we've done at UCSD, which is happening at MD Anderson and other major cancer centers, where palliative medicine is right there in the clinic, seeing patients alongside everyone else in the cancer care team. And we mustn't rest. We must make sure that future research improves our ability to relieve suffering and improve quality of life. So what should patients do? What should you do? Well, the most important thing that you can do is to speak up, to avoid the conspiracy of silence. For so many of these issues I've been touching on, patients feel like they cannot bring it up to their oncologist. They don't want to bother them. They don't want to worry them. They don't want to imply criticism of their oncologist. The data is very clear. Oncologists want patients to bring it up, but are waiting for the patients to bring it up. The patient data suggests that they're waiting for the oncologist to bring it up. You can see what the conspiracy of silence it is. Talking about your worries, talking about your fears, won't diminish the chance of a cure. It doesn't make the cancer drugs or the radiation or the surgery work any less well. In fact, the data is actually very strong. The more you deal with what's bothering you, the better the therapy will work. So it won't, just talking about your fears about death doesn't mean that death will happen sooner. The data is strong that this actually leads to a better cancer care experience. Your doctor is waiting for you. My second piece of advice is you need to expect the relief of suffering as part of comprehensive cancer care. If symptoms aren't coming under control, ask for a palliative medicine consult. Ask for that expertise. Find it because it is there available for you. I'm aware that specialists trained in this field are still in relatively short supply across the country. So what can your doctor do in the interim? Well, one possibility that we have at the Institute for Palliative Medicine is the PalMed Connect hotline. Your doctor, this is a hotline for doctors, as well as for nurse practitioners and pharmacists, to get that information, to get that peer-to-peer advice from experts in the field. What do I do about this person's pain that is persisting? What do I do about this person's ongoing nausea or the sense of fatigue? There are answers, and the number is shown on this slide. So the ground we've covered is pretty broad. Palliative care, it's relief of suffering and improving quality of life. What's the evolution? It started in hospice care, but it now extends across the trajectory of care for anyone with mesothelioma or lung cancer. There is a specialist physician role in addition to what your oncologist can provide. And the challenge is for each of us to expect palliative care to be part of that cancer care continuum. Well, what about the future? What we're here at the Institute for Palliative Medicine, what we're interested in is preparing a future that is better than what we have now, and that includes physician training, medical students, residents, specialist fellows. One of the things that physicians must learn in order to incorporate palliative care into their practice is a sense of what is the field and what are the rewards. One of the activities that we ask everyone to do who comes to us for training is to do a personal project that reflects their personal engagement with the relief of suffering and improving quality of life. What I want to show you now is one of those personal projects. And as you watch this, I want you to think, what is this doctor learning about palliative care as it relates to the care of patients with cancer?
Thank you.
So I hope what you saw in there is not what you expected. I hope you saw love, joy, a sense of being able to accomplish important things, a sense of appreciating beauty and love and what it is to be alive in this world. Over and over, of all the physicians that we train and now, nurses, social workers, chaplains, counselors, pharmacists, this sense of empowerment that this even in the face of serious illness, there is much that can be done. That sense of hopefulness, that positive feeling is something that I hope that you take away from this talk. This is something to expect as part of your cancer care.